Hello students, once again I am welcoming you in my lecture session on electromagnetic theory for physics 2 third semester BTech course. Now the streams under consideration are computer science and engineering as well as information technology. Today myself Dr. Sucharita Bhattacharya, subject teacher of physics from Guru Nanak Institute of Technology, Kolkata, is going to deliver lecture number 13. Now, what is there in this lecture number 13? Actually, you all know that we are continuing the module 4 of the Physics 2 code PH301 on electromagnetic theory. The total number of lectures included is 11, just the theory portions, covering the theory portions. Now today I am delivering submodule 4.04. Basically, I am going to start the submodule 4.04 on electromagnetic wave and polarization. Total number of lectures allocated there is 3, which includes the definition, plane of polarization, plane of vibration, Malus's law, then fundamental concepts of plane, circular and elliptic polarization. Only qualitative idea we will try to give as per our syllabus with examples. And then we will go for Brewster's law, the phenomenon of double refraction including ordinary and extraordinary rays. Then Nicol's prism will be discussed along with engineering applications in electromagnetic theory. And definitely I will go for the numerical problems. And as you know, for numerical problems, I may need one extra class because I want to deliver it in a slightly different way for your convenience. Now, definitely the books under consideration will be available to you from our website, www.gnit.ac.in syllabus. Okay. Now, what about the objective of our course on module 4? That is the electromagnetic theory will provide exposure to the foundations of electrostatics, magnetostatics, electromagnetic induction, which ultimately helps to reach Maxwell's field equations, thus highlighting the nature of electromagnetic wave, including their polarization property. Actually, up to this, we already have reached. So today we are trying to relate the nature of electromagnetic wave with polarization property. This knowledge is applied in communication and networking. So what about the course outcome of you students? After completion of this course, you will be able to understand and explain the phenomenon of electrostatics, magnetostatics, and electromagnetic theory. Also, you will be able to apply the knowledge of electromagnetic theory in communication and networking. And you will be analyze the change. You will be rather able to analyze the change in electric and magnetic fields in various systems. So, let us now come to the today's lesson. I already mentioned that in submodule 4.04, the 3 lectures are allocated. So in our today's lesson, that is in first lesson, we are starting obviously with an introduction, then definition of the polarization, then plane of polarization, plane of vibration will be discussed. After that, we will go for the Malus's law. Naturally, the questions to be addressed in today's session is, what about transverse and the longitudinal waves? Next, we will demonstrate polarization. That means how to demonstrate polarization. From this part onward, I will do the things in whiteboard, physical whiteboard. Then, really polarization is associated with transverse waves only, that we will deliver. After that, we will go for the definition of polarization. That means what about polarization? Next, what about polarization? What about plane of polarization? What about plane of vibration? Then we will go for Malus's law. Okay. And today what I will do, I will divide the entire session into two parts. In the first part, that means here in lecture 13A, I will discuss about the introduction part and the transverse and the longitudinal wave part. And the rest of the things will be delivered in lesson 13B, that means second session, where I will use the whiteboard for your convenience. Okay. Now, any electromagnetic wave, already we have seen that consisting of light, X-ray, visible light, ultraviolet light, gamma ray, cosmic ray, everything consists of a coupled of oscillating electric and magnetic fields, which are always perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So all electromagnetic waves are transverse in character. Now here, we are mainly concentrating or focusing on light because in our day-to-day life, we always encounter light maximally, which is a very, very important member of the electromagnetic wave family. And definitely, it is made up of a coupled oscillating electric and magnetic field, which are discussed in terms of sinusoidal wave variations, which are always perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to direction of propagation. Now, it is the physical phenomenon of polarization which conclusively proves that electromagnetic waves like light are transverse in character, where by convention, the polarization of electromagnetic waves refers to the direction of electric field only. Okay. Now, Huygens was the first person who made the fundamental discovery of polarization in 1690, way back. Huygens first made the fundamental discovery of polarization way back in 1690, and it was Malus who conducted series of experiments to verify Huygens' theory of light, including polarization, and express it in analytical form. So definitely we will just take a look on both parts, that means Huygens' contribution as well as Malus's contribution in this chapter on polarization. Now before going to that part, let us first consider recapitulate what about transverse and longitudinal wave, because with these you are familiar from your school level. But since the phenomenon of polarization is associated with transverse wave, so not with longitudinal wave, before giving to that conclusion, let us first recapitulate what about transverse and longitudinal wave. If the vibrations of the particle of a wave is along the direction of propagation of the wave, corresponding waves are termed as longitudinal waves, like sound waves. But if the vibrations of the particles of a wave is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave, waves are called the transverse waves. Now, let us take a look at the diagram here, that this is the longitudinal wave. Just take a look. It is made up of compressions and rarefactions of different layers of the vibration of the particle. That means the vibration of the particle is along the direction of propagation of the wave. This is the direction of propagation of the wave along which the energy is transferred from one layer to other in the form of vibration of the particles, which are termed as compression, where high pressure is there, and this is the portion rarefactions where pressure is released. And this is the property of the longitudinal wave. Now, what about the transverse wave? Just take a look. This is the pictorial representation of a transverse wave, which is made up of alternating crest and trough. That means vibrations of the particle are perpendicular to direction of propagation of the wave. Because of these vibrations, we are getting the maximum point where vibration, position of maximum vibration, that is called the crest, and position of minimum vibration, that is called the trough. But mind it, here direction of propagation is perpendicular to direction of propagation of the wave. That's why the name transverse came, because it means the vibration is perpendicular to direction of propagation, and this is longitudinal. So along the direction of propagation, vibrations we are getting, and definitely this transverse wave is very, very important so far as electromagnetic wave phenomenon is concerned, where light is a very, very important member, and we encounter it in our daily life always. Okay, so now we will move to the next part of today's session, that is 13B, which I will demonstrate through physical white board. Okay, so thank you, students. Let us concentrate in our next portion. Okay.